Yes, definitely. So there are six users here online, no? So let us start. So you can put your queries or you can put your suggestions at Rankers app also. In Rankers app, we are live. You can put your suggestions there. So only one is there, Raghav is there. No problem. So in case you want to be face to face, you can join the Google Meet. Google Meet link has already been sent to you. So you can join there also. Or in case you want to put your queries through chat box, you can put at chat box also. Right? So let us start with the question number one. Question number one was surprisingly different. It is management versus organization. See, when you answer any question in organization theory, your focus should be the key contents or key issues and concepts of organization theory. That is organization goals, organization structure, organization culture, right? And you must also know the key objective of organization theory. So key objective of anything in organization theory is efficient and effective resource use. So that should be the criteria of writing any answer, right? So in management versus organization, you were expected to focus more on organization because your syllabus is more about organization. You are expected. Oh, let me do one thing. I will take it in other device. I'll take it in. Right. Here I will be better able to control it. So when you are answering any question, your focus should be on organization. Management is a general term that includes organization also. Definitely in your answer, you should have written the meaning of management, meaning of organization. Right. What else we should write here, Raman? Yes, similarities should have been written. What are the similarities? So most important point of similarity is that both of them deal with human element. And both of these aim at efficient and effective resource use, right? But there are differences. So we could make a table on differences, management versus organization. So but in conclusion, you should show cause-effect relationship. So management and organization are interrelated with one another. Okay. If there is good organization, there would be good management. And if there is good management, there would be good organization. But one important thing is, whatever management you are having, good organization is essential. You must have learned somewhere a CEO of a company told that you can take all of our properties, means you can take everything, but don't take our organization. With the help of a good organization, we can create good management, we can create infrastructure. So that must have been the driving force, that must have been the key for the examiner to give good marks. So write that good organization is essential for quality of management. Organization is lost, management gets weak. And there is resource wastage, right? And today, you can use IT. IT can be used particularly today to make organizations effective and management efficient, right? For example, EVA at HDFC Bank. So it is not organization, it is just a tool. So even management can work without organization also due to use of IT, right? Any onliner having any query, you can put your suggestion or your query in the chat box. Query here. So let us move to the next question. Organization culture by Charles Handy. So it is a question on specific models. Question on specific model. So what we should write in introduction?
We could start with definition of organization culture.
Right. We could start with the definition of organization culture. And here also that is answer starts with the definition of organization culture. And my suggestion is we must mention names of four or five theories of organization culture. Four or five theories of organization culture. And Charles Handy's theory is one among them. Right? Charles Handy's. So various theories of organization cultures you could start with. And thereafter, Charles Handy. Charles Handy provided elements of any organization culture. Any organization culture may have power culture, task culture, person culture, role culture. If you see power culture, for example, Prime Minister's office, PMO. So in PMO, you'll find a power culture. In superintendent of police office, you'll find power culture. Because here, main task is use of power to make decisions or use of power to allocate resources. Right? So example must be given. Sir, will this updated model answer be provided? Yes, we can provide. So definitely the answer on which I have annotated, I will provide that also. So no need to write yourself, right? And you can write task culture. A task culture is one where instead of power, task is important. Task is important. For example, ICU. In ICU, task performed by the nurses, task performed by various workers, that is more important. And another is person culture. Person culture, for example, CA firm, for example, doctors. In case of CAs, in case of doctors, so in a complete organization, persons are dominant. They are drivers of the culture, right? And in role culture, for example, filmmaking, role culture, you can say character culture, that is important. In case of project work, right? So these types of cultures are found. Definitely in this case, these diagrams are drawn very beautifully. That in case of power culture, PM is at center stage, or in case of SP's office, SP is at center stage. In case of role culture, you could write in case of task culture. So different persons in the organization, they play their task. So hundreds of tasks are there. And combination of tasks becomes complete role. Right? In ICU, you can't say that nurse is having a big role. They perform various tasks. Right? And what else could be written here? I think. Yes, merits can be written. That high power culture cannot be applied everywhere. For example, in a hospital, high power culture is not useful. It can be useful in case of military organization, particularly in case of PMO, in case of decision making bodies, it is, right? And another thing. Organization development is required to develop task culture. That is very important. Because ultimately organizations survive and get success through task culture. Right? And you can say that today this theory is highly useful in view of increased significance of individuals and greater power with individuals. So person culture, power culture. So these find important. And in every organization, you will find mix of all of these four cultures. We can't say that a particular organization will be having any one culture only. In case of hospital also, for example, at Medanta Medicity, so this Naresh Tarhan, he comes under power culture and role culture. The person is powerful as well as role, right? Yes, organization. You can write that organizations have subcultures. So defining any organization from just one perspective would be narrow approach, right? And one thing you could write, our theory resembles with Mintzberg approach to five structural form of organization. Mintzberg, centralized structure is there, adocracy is there, machine bureaucracy is there, professional bureaucracy is there. So if you connect any theory with another theory, it makes your answer more authentic. It shows that while making decisions, because in bureaucracy, you will be judged from the decision-making perspective. So if you can connect one theory with another, it means you can apply that properly. Right? Theory of Grekunov's, let us see. Grekunov's theory is concerned with span of management. It is concerned with span of control. Span of control. So you should not answer any theory in isolation. You should not answer any theory in isolation. So where to write span of control in complete organization theory? In complete organization theory, span of control is linked with the, it is linked with the span of control. It is linked with the organization design. When you develop organization, when you prepare organization structure, in preparing organization structure, you have to write span of control. So you should have written this. It is written here that span of control is an important, span of control is an important determinant of organization structure. Are there other members here?
No.
No one is there? Okay. So isko to mere din se fir off kar dena chahiye because people are connected here. Theek hai na? So it is an important determinant of organization structure. So Grekunov's theory provides measure of span with given number of subordinates. So fir main mic ko haath mein le lunga na.
When you are having point, you will take lead, right? So thereafter, you will mention the core of the theory. It deals with superior subordinate relationship. Thereafter, three important elements of span of control. So then you define it. But our point of focus should be how it is linked with the organization design or organization structure, right? Some any unique point you are having? It is covered well. Yes, it covers well. And to me, in conclusion, you should write. That for better control in organization, appropriate span is essential. Power of IT can be used to increase or enhance span and work with wide span. Right? That could be written. Right? And you could write